Thank you so much, loved ones, for joining me. In the chair, I got world-famous artist Jennifer Corson. Say hi, Jenny.
Hi.
We're going to rap a little bit about this and that and the other thing. First, I got for you Four Hero. Morning Child is a great song. Check it out, loved ones. Thank you. The name of that band, Morning Child, from the Play With Changes album that was out in 2007 on the Raw Canvas label. Next up, the great Al Wilson, Show and Tell. This is some baby making music right here. Check it out.
These are the eyes that never knew how to smile till you into my life. And these are the arms that long to lock you inside every day and every night. Girl, and here is the soul of which you've taken control. Can't you see I'm trying?
Pentagram was the name of that band. Fall in Love was the name of the tune. Off of their second LP, their latest LP called Voices, out on the Republic Records label. That LP is it's forthcoming. It's not expected to come out until February 18th. That's a great tune. I researched a little bit in that tune. It's produced by John Hill, known for his work with Santa Gold and MIA and his big fat bass line. They're playing February 23rd at the Palladium. Excuse me. So if you like that tune, check out their record coming out this month. Stop by the old Palladium there. Check out Fantagram. Prior to that, we heard Al Wilson from San Bernardino, California. Mr. Al Wilson, Show and Tell. I got that from his greatest hits record. The song was originally put out in 1973. It's a Johnny Mathis cover, and started off with a Four Hero, Morning Child. Did you like those songs? World famous artist Jennifer Corson. Yeah. You pull that mic just a little bit closer to you. There you go. Jennifer Corson comes to us. She's a Hollywood resident.
Better?
Yeah, much better.
Okay.
And Jennifer Corson.
Yes, Jennifer Corson.
There we are, okay. Little audio glitch.
All right.
Jennifer Corson resides in Hollywood. How's Hollywood treating you? The East Hollywood.
East Hollywood,
side,
Summer
right?
Lake, yeah.
Yeah. How's that treating you?
I love it.
Yeah, good eats?
Good eats, good yeah. Everything. Mm-hmm.
Is there a Mr. World Famous artist Jennifer Corson?
No.
No?
There's not.
Yeah, would you, is that intentional?
Yeah, right now, mm-hmm. Definitely.
Okay. Well, how do you, put a lot into a lot of personal work in your paintings.
Yeah, I put everything into it.
But you're not necessarily just a painter, right?
No, I do a little bit of everything, which is why I don't have time for anything else, really. Mm-hmm. Painting, drawing, or making jewelry. I'm just kind of art ADD.
Mm-hmm. Art ADD, yeah.
Art ADD, art tad.
Mm-hmm. That's cool. And you, let me see, you have a lot of different pop-up shows, things like that. I know you have a residence over at Hive Gallery, is
yeah.
That correct?
I do, and I'm going to be featured there next month, so that's kind of a new, exciting thing.
Oh, no shit.
Installation,
cool.
So. Yeah.
And do you make a living as an artist?
I do. I take freelance art related jobs when I can, sometimes teaching and things like that, but it's all art related.
Mm-hmm. And if somebody wanted to check out some of your work, they would go to, what was it, Humans Make Art?
Mm-hmm. Humansmakeart.com or at Humans Make Art on Instagram. That's probably the most frequently updated and most annoying and better glimpse of exactly what I'm doing.
Excellent, excellent. So what do you do for fun then besides just create art? Or you just, that's it, you just submerge yourself in that creative
yeah,
world?
Yeah, I'm really immersed. I mean, I don't really spend a lot of time doing anything else or around people that aren't doing similar things. I'm kind of saving up my social life for next year, hopefully.
Yeah.
Do some more non-art yeah. things.
Mm-hmm. Who are some of your art buddies, I guess?
Oh, man. I have a lot of art buddies. Paula's Hard, I hang out with a lot. Hannah Streety, Pelletier. I'm hesitant to name people because then I'm not going to name the right people.
Yeah, for sure. Who do you know their work of and you would like to know socially?
Wow.
You could just pick one out of a hat.
I think Nychos. He's my favorite.
Mm-hmm.
And I would like to know him personally and be able to watch him paint kind of creepily.
Yeah, how come?
It'd be fun. Just the way he paints is gorgeous, and his compositions are really spread out and amazing.
Mm-hmm.
I have a lot of admiration just for... I've seen him paint once, but just the way he can manipulate it and get it looking like I don't know if I could ever do.
Yeah. What could you describe your work in a short little bit? Like, using your own words. Don't think about this as, like, some sort of press release. Like,
okay.
Think of it as a... You know... Think of it as you're telling St. Peter.
I guess I'd say it's pop anatomy, if that makes sense. Or, I mean, a lot. It's all different. It's
yeah.
hearts, lots of hearts, different yeah. mediums, woodcuts. been painting a lot of murals recently. Yeah, mostly heart related for the last 2 years, I'd say. Yeah. Maybe that'll go away soon. Branching into payphones.
I definitely want to talk to you a little bit more about that. Can you stick around for a bit?
Yeah, I guess I can.
Okay, we're going to play a little bit more music. This is a newish group, Tennis. Their husband and wife duo, Kurt Keard of Youth, is the name of the tune. Slipping in the Dark is the name of the tune. Before that, we heard Frankie Beverly and Mays, While I'm Alone. It's a good kind of quiet storm music by way of San Francisco. Started off with a new group named Tennis. As I mentioned, they're a husband and wife duo. Cured of Youth from their Small Sound EP. It's on the Communion label. They have an LP expected this year at some point. So, I know how it is, world famous artist, Jennifer Corson. You're out and about, let's say you're in the San Fernando Valley and you got a hankering to buy some vinyl or used CDs, but you just don't want to pay top dollar for them, right?
Yeah.
I got a solution for you, my friend.
What is it?
You can stop by CD Trader over there in Tarzana.
I love CD Trader.
Yeah, they're great. And you know what? Now, as a listener of the show, if you go into CD Trader, it's located at 18926 Ventura Boulevard in Tarzana, California. And you mentioned you're a listener of the show and you heard it on the show, Neighborhood Love Radio. They're going to give you 10% off of all merchandise. Vinyl, from LPs to 45s, used CDs. Cassette tapes. They have cassettes.
That is incredible.
They have cassettes, yes.
And you just mentioned the show?
Yep. Just mentioned Neighborhood Love Radio.
Wow.
At CD Trader in Tarzana, California. So let's say you're out there out and about and you got your brand new music and you're feeling a little bit, you know, feeling a little spunky. Maybe you want to go get a tattoo, but gosh darn, top shelf work is so expensive, tattoo work. So you know what you could do? Just drive right on over to Canoga Park to Nathan's Tattoo and Piercing, a new sponsor for the show, by the way. And they if you mention you heard about it on Neighborhood Love Radio, they'll give you 20% off of all jewelry and services.
Wow.
And hats. And you've been there before.
Absolutely.
Like, they have a whole stable full of bomb-ass artists, and tattoo work can get pretty pricey. 20%. Which is, so if you got a $500 tattoo, that's, I have to take
the
shoes off.
The Nathan's experience is priceless, though.
It is. 20% off all merchandise and services by mentioning Neighborhood Love Radio at Nathan's Tattoo and Piercing in Canoga Park. 7222 Topanga Canyon Boulevard in Canoga Park, California, God's country. Nathan's Tattoo and Piercing in Canoga Park. CD Trader in Tarzana, both new sponsors for the show. Thank you so much, guys. And okay, world famous artist Jennifer Corson, mentioned a little bit earlier that your website was humansmakeart.com. Artmakingart.com.
Yeah.
Do you what do you get out of making art? Like and I know there's going to be a polished some sort of polished answer, but
no.
Like where do you see it benefiting your life in maybe a non-social level?
It's definitely not social. It's the opposite of that. But it makes me happy. I mean, it makes me feel like I'm spending my time in a productive way that I feel good about at the end of the day.
And what do you, where do you see, dumb question, where do you see yourself in 5 years, you know? But what do you see yourself getting out of it that you don't have now?
Hopefully, eventually I could make a living selling my art exclusively and not having to take odd jobs and do all that, but I think balance is really important too, and when I get too immersed and too busy with art, I crave outside stuff too, so.
So, as all artists communication, you're saying that you currently have a creative outlet and therefore communication, but you want to see it to where you make a living off of it as well?
I mean, there's nothing else I want to spend my time doing, and I've had people say to me things like, well, I don't make art to make money, but I mean, it's really all I want to do. And
but you need money to live.
You absolutely do. And
so
why
not
take time away from what you're passionate about and what, you know, you feel good doing? If you like teaching, you're going to be a teacher and want to make a living doing it. And I like that too. But making art is rewarding on a lot of different levels. And seeing people respond to it it's really amazing.
Excellent. So where do you see that as far as communication goes? Where do you see yourself communicating in a couple years?
What
do you see the emotional, the emotional quality of your work?
I mean, my work is very emotional as it is. I don't know if it could get any more emotional, but...
could you elaborate?
I think a lot of the hearts and some of the sayings I use, I think I come off very kind of emo and a lot girlier than I think people who know me would say that I am. But I think that's kind of like what that's an outlet for me.
What is your art missing?
I don't know. I just kind of do it. I don't think about that. What is it missing? You tell me.
I don't know. I mean, it's missing everything
animals
in the world
that
it's not.
A lot of animals.
But it's not, you know?
Yeah.
But as far as a clear, straightforward communication, I mean, it speaks to me definitely. The Heart series, but more than that, some of your little side gigs, you know, that you're not maybe a little bit less well known for. I like your that doll.
Oh,
the
yeah,
doll series you did a couple years back, and that was super creepy and awesome.
Thank you.
But beautiful work, just the brushwork on it, you know, there's a lot of depth, and I mean it's hard to paint flat.
Yeah, plastic,
you know, flat color plastic, you know.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Painting like that, I'm just not that attracted to anymore. It's a little too thought out. I like to be kind of more expressive and quick with my work. Like I want to just kind of do it and then figure out what it's doing afterwards, rather than planning like exactly where every little brush stroke's going to go and how to flatten this and blend that. So, I mean, that's a whole other thing, but.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, I'm just kind of vomiting out art constantly.
Do you have a ritual?
I tend to wake up and make art in my pajamas for the first couple hours of the day. I just want to like roll out of bed, make coffee, eat a banana sometimes, and just kind of get to it. And I think that can look kind of strange. I'll be in my front yard woodworking and stuff. And, but I just like to get into it, and then I can take a break and do other stuff. That's the only real ritual.
Real fast, loved ones, I want to make sure to mention that Jennifer Corson's website is humansmakeart.com. She is a resident artist at the Hive Gallery, and she's also a featured artist upcoming. What's the date on that feature?
The opening is February 8th. I'll be a featured installation artist. It's my first time doing like a big installation in a gallery, so it should be exciting.
Excellent. And could you tell me a little bit about Fame Fest?
Yes, Fame Fest is put on by Space 23, which used to be called Ethos Gallery at Melrose in Fairfax.
I know it,
The Fame Yard, it's like a street art graffiti yard that a lot of different artists paint in. So they kind of open it up, have bands and food trucks and artwork, and it's a good time.
Yeah, excellent.
And the artists are usually there, and it's kind of a fun social thing, and I would recommend it.
What are you scared of as an artist?
I was going to say rejection, but I'm not scared of that anymore. I think that kind of makes you a little stronger and calls you on your shit, kind of.
It's inevitable.
Yeah, and it kind of, definitely when you get rejected and then a couple years later, I mean, those people will come to you, and that's a good feeling.
Yeah. What are some other things you're scared of as not necessarily pertaining to your art career?
Not about art?
Well, not about your art career, per se.
I guess running out of inspiration or just becoming, like, caught up in something that would take away from my art and not realizing it.
Like a relationship?
Yeah. Definitely. Mm-hmm.
Do you want to have kids someday?
I'm not even thinking about that at all. Mm-hmm. I could adopt a 10-year-old in 10 years and feel really good about it.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I'm not thinking about, it all.
So you could adopt a 10-year-old? Okay. So loved ones all within earshot of my voice. If you're planning on conceiving right around now and you don't know if you got the wherewithal to stick it out for 10 years, keep this in mind. Keep a copy of the show handy. Make sure to save it on whatever listening devices we have in 10 years.
Right. And follow Humans Make Art on Instagram.
Yeah. What do you think we'll be using in 10 years as far as personal communication devices, phones, or otherwise?
Man, I don't know that we're going to need them in 10 years. We're pretty close.
Mm-hmm. You don't think it's going to be some chip embedded in our teeth or something?
I think it would be something like that, but it would feel so organic that we don't even think of it that way. It's just your giant thought brain or something.
Yeah. I think, it could be that some sort of personal chip or part of our...
you have to add people to be able to communicate with them.
Yeah. Also, maybe, just maybe, they'll have the 405 freeway done by then, too.
Or maybe we'll go back to payphones. Mm-hmm.
That'll be cool. There's one downstairs. Did you notice that?
Yes.
Yeah. It's not ready for you yet. There's an actual phone there.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Hey, this is Sharon Jones and the Dap Kings. I'm not sure if you know her story, but she's a very recent cancer survivor. She's been, she's an old jail corrections officer. She was a waitress, and she's a bomb-ass singer, man. This is a Shuggie Otis cover called Inspiration Information by Miss Sharon Jones and the Dap Kings. Enjoy, please. Danish Soul from Quadron. Neverland is the name of the tune from the Avalanche record, out in last year, 2013. This is brand new music from Prince, Da Bourgeois.
Yesterday, I saw you kicking it with another girl. You was all wrapped up around her waist. I checked, you said you left the dirty world. Well, it appears that wasn't the case. Hey, I see you're undercover like the CIA, snatching little wigs from another cat. That's French. I guess a man's only good for a rainy day. Or maybe you're just another beauty lady at the cabaret. Ray Charles even saw you in the past before we saw me. Cause nothing like you ever lasts for eternity. I got the receipt, babe, but where's the guarantee? I forgot, fake as a Christmas tree. Everybody step right up and come and see the bearded lady. Take me up to G. Ooh. making it with another girl. You was all wrapped up around her waist. Last time I checked, you said you left a dirty world. Well, it appears it wasn't the case. Hey, I see you undercover like the CIA.
Song must be out.
No more rainy days. Just another bearded lady at the cabaret. Charles, just another bearded lady at the cabaret. Charles, just another bearded lady at the cabaret. Charles.
That was brand new music by Prince. Can't get it online. If you look up Prince's Twitter, he's got a link to it. But there's no former LP that I know of coming up. Hey, check this out. This is Fat Freddy's Drop from New Zealand. Matthews Drop is the name of the band from New Zealand. Good stuff. Anyway, I want to do a quickly mention, now that I'm still sitting here with world-famous artist Jennifer Corson. She has got a current exhibit at the Gabba Gallery all the way till March 1st, that ends?
Yes, somewhere around then. Platforms and Paint, all females.
All females, yeah. Mm. So there's probably some fine-looking piece sitting around there somewhere.
Definitely.
Yeah. Also a current resident artist at the Hive Gallery, upcoming featured artist at the Hive Gallery.